لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، مكور الليل على النهار ومكور النهار على الليل، سخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لاجل مسمى، يقلب الليل والنهار إن في ذلك لعبرة لأولي الأبصار. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في سنته: نعمتان مغبون فيهما كثير من الناس، الصحة والفراغ. Two blessings that people who do not, two blessings that people do not appreciate in their way. The free time they have and the health and the good health that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today is the first day in the Gregorian calendar. So we started a new year, and yesterday we said goodbye to a previous year that was full of pains and gains, suffering, a lot of death because of coronavirus, a lot of hardships, many people lost their jobs, a lot of things happened in our life. And because we have some youth and some teens here, I want to address them with something that they feel it, but they sometimes cannot speak it up. Sheikh, you say Islam is easy, but we find it hard to practice. This is a question that our kids have, and we need to find an answer for their brothers and sisters. But let us first, dear brothers and sisters, look at the other nations. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala imposed upon them things that they suffered a lot because of that. And alhamdulillah, Allah freed us from these burdens that they have. Imagine, dear brothers and sisters, if you commit a sin, everyone in the community would know that you committed a sin. How bad then I would be in this situation. That every person passes by your car or by your door will find out that he committed this sin in this day, and the way to wipe it out is to do this and that. It would be a nightmare for everyone. It would be a gloomy life. Everyone knows about me that I committed shameful things. Because we do, we commit sins. And alhamdulillah that the sins do not have a smell, otherwise it will smell so bad. Allah remove this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove this burden, dear brothers and sisters. You commit whatever you commit from the sins, nobody knows about it. And you are not allowed to speak up and say, I did this and this. No. Allah will forgive for your sins as long as you are hiding this between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah give us as Muslims this favor, that our sins are between Allah, the Almighty, and between ourselves. And we are not allowed to speak up. But before, the sins to be forgiven should be written on the door of every person. Imagine, dear brothers and sisters, if we make a mistake or a sin by mistake, and by forgetfulness, we are responsible for it. I made a mistake, I made a sin, and I didn't mean it. I made it unintentionally. I'm still accountable for it. If I do something out of forgetfulness, I'm still responsible for it. Those are burdens, dear brothers and sisters, that the people before us had. Even if you have something in your heart, so you have whispers, I will commit sins, this sin, I will do this and this to that person. Even if you have something inside you, even if you didn't speak up before, us, you are accountable for it. But in Islam, if you make anything by mistakes, you are forgiven for it. No matter whatever you did, as long as it is out of your control. If you divorce your wife and you were in extreme anger, it doesn't count. If the person, you know, lost a salah because he was sleeping, he's forgiving. This is, you know, what Islam taught us, dear brothers and sisters. Islam removed all these burdens from us. If I have something bad in my heart towards anyone, and as long as it is inside me and it doesn't appear, then alhamdulillah, I'm forgiven for it. Imagine, dear brothers and sisters, if we have to pray 50 times a day, how would be our life? How do we sleep? How do we work? How do we eat? All these were burdens that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moved us from the way. And add to this, that every time we make dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla, that says, رَبَّنَا وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ. This ayah, the last ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, that has this part in which we say, Ya Allah, do not impose upon us things that are beyond our control. Every time we say this dua, what happens? Allah will answer and would say, I did. The Prophet Muhammad used to choose the easier matters as long as it's a halal. The Prophet Muhammad says, the best of your deen, the easiest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا جَعَلْ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. Allah does not intend any hardship for you in the matters of the worship. If I cannot pray because, you know, I'm sick, I can make it while I'm sitting down or I'm laying down. If I'm traveling, because of traveling and the hardship, I combine the salah and shorten the salah. When we leave the salah, we are highly recommended to make the salah so short, so we will not give a hard time. During these days, we should give and make the khutbah so short because of the situation. Alhamdulillah, we cannot pray together and beside each other. Now we have a distance now because we want to care for everyone. People, you know, could not make it because they are old, then they are forgiving and they can pray at home. This is the deen of Islam. But we'll get back to the question of our teens. Having said that, why it's hard? I'm in the school now, it's time for salah. I find it hard to tell my teacher, oh, it's time for salah and I want to pray. It's hard for me as a girl to wear the hijab and they look at me and I look different. They will say, oh, maybe that I'm a tourist. You know, they eat everything and I'm not allowed to eat pork. I'm not allowed except the bi'ah. This gives me a hard time. They are allowed to celebrate the Christmas and to exchange gifts. And I'm not allowed. A lot of things they do and I do not do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it harder for us. And Sheikh, you said that Islam is the deen of ease by Quran and Sunnah. And by all these things that you are narrating to us. So, the reason why Islam is hard to practice, why we see a lot of people do not practice Islam because of few things. One of them is our, and before I say this, subhanAllah, nowadays we have the people who do not practice. In the past they didn't have this. They asked the Mufti in Morocco like 700 years ago. And they said to him, what is the ruling concerning the person who does not pray, who does not perform the prayers? You know what was the answer of the Mufti? He said that this is a hypothetical condition that we don't have in our communities. How many Muslims in Mekini here that we do not have? The people who come to the masjid here, I can guess they are 30 or 40% of the Muslims. And everybody else, the brothers and sisters, is not practicing the deen. So, getting back to the question why Islam is hard to practice, number one, because of our concept about Islam. What does Islam mean? I am a Muslim. What does it mean? Does it mean that I come to Jum'ah and that's it? I eat the bi'ah and that's it? I pray Taraweeh and that's it? Islam is a way of life that as a teen, you should practice whether you are in the school or in the street or at home or at work or anywhere. You are a Muslim 24 hours. You are a Muslim all the time. It's not restricted to some rituals. You pray Jum'ah and pray five salat and that's it. No, it's a way of life all the time. You are Muslim. You are a Muslim when you deal with non-Muslims. You are a Muslim when you deal with your classmates, with your workmates, with your neighbors, when you work, when you buy, when you sell, when you do anything, you are a Muslim. So Islam is a way of life that you should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah tells you pray, but you do it out of love. You do it out of love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not like something you do it to get rid of it. No. When Allah tells you wear the hijab, I wear the hijab because I love what Allah tells me. When Allah tells me do not drink wine, I know that there is a wisdom behind and I do it for the sake of Allah. I love Allah. I say to everyone around me that I'm a Muslim. I do not change my name because I like people to be happy with me. Now I'm a Muslim, pleasing Allah is number one, takes the first priority in my life. This is the way that I represent Islam. This is the way that Islam will be easy for me. And this is the only point that we will mention because of the time, inshallah, bi-idhnillah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll continue, inshallah, in the second khutbah, and maybe in another khutbah we'll continue the reason that make it hard for us to practice Islam, especially in non-Muslims, لَنْ تُوْهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ يَدْرُ عَلِيْهُ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Why Islam is hard? The reason number one that we look at Islam as something that is restricted to the worship's only. And we don't use it as a way of life. As a Muslim, I submit myself to Allah. All my life is for Allah. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسِكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I'm a Muslim and I want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the first priority in my life. If my work doesn't match with Islam, I don't need it. If my work doesn't allow me to pray Jum'ah, I don't need it. If my job allows me to make haram, then I'm not happy with this job because I'm losing my hereafter. And I'm losing my deen, and the deen is my blood and my flesh. I pray, I announce my identity because I'm a Muslim. And I'm proud of this in front of everyone. I do not hide it because I love Allah. And I know that Allah created me in this land to worship Him, which means that to do the worships and do whatever pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the meaning of worship. That is not restricted to certain rituals. Eid, and I come to Eid. That's why we have thousands of people for Eid. And in Salat al-Jum'ah, alhamdulillah, a less number. For the other salawat, 20% of the people who come for Salat al-Eid. Why, dear brothers and sisters? Because we look at Islam as some rituals that we should practice. The brothers who are outside, you can, inshallah, enter inside with the social distance, inshallah. Jazakumullah. We'll finish within 2 minutes, inshallah. What I want to tell you, my teens, my younger ones, that the people of falsehood, they are defending their desires, and they defending their trivial things that they believe in, and they are ready to sacrifice their life. They love to do and to sacrifice everything for the sake of their corruption. In the past, dear brothers and sisters, a person was taking care of his wife or his beloved one, and she was sick. Like today, if someone is suffering from COVID-19 and he's in quarantine, you cannot get closer to him. What this Bedouin man did? He went and he took care of his beloved one who was sick, and they told him, it's a contagious. You can pick the disease. Because he loved her. What did he say? He says, وَأَحْسَبُ الْعَدْوَى مِنْ غَيْرِكُمْ هَمٌّ وَسِقَمٌ لَكِنَّ الْعَدْوَى مِنْكُمُ أَحْلَى مِنَ الْعَسَلِ. If the disease comes to me from anyone else, oh, something I do not tolerate. But if it comes from the one whom I love, then for me, it's dearer to my heart than honey. See, dear brothers and sisters,
How his love to a human exceeds all the limits. Majnun Layla, somebody who loved Layla. And because she left him, he used to go to her house and just go to the walls of every side of the door and kissing the stones. أَمُرُّ عَلَى الدِّيَارِ دِيَارِ لَيْلَى أُقَبِّلُ ذَا الْجِدَارِ وَذَا الْجِدَارِ وَمَا حُبُّ الْجِدَارِ شَغَلْنَا وَمَا حُبُّ الدِّيَارِ شَغَلْنَا قَلْبِي وَلَكُنْ حُبُّ مَنْ سَكَنَ الدِّيَارِ. What type of person is this? They found him dead, you know, between the stones, among the stones, because he was mad because of his love. What about your love to Allah? The one who created us, the one who saved us, the one who guided us to Islam, the one who granted us the rizq. Through COVID-19, dear brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, nobody died from hunger. Allah saved us. Allah gave us to be Muslims. Allah gave us to Islam. Allah granted us, alhamdulillah, the health. Allah granted us a lot of blessings. Dear brothers and sisters, in the last year that we had, you know how many minutes we have? We have more than 1,000,000 minutes. That each minute can bring for you a lot of reward and hasanat. How many heartbeats we had? We had more than 40 million heartbeats. How many times we breathe in a whole year? We breathe, dear brothers and sisters, for more than 11 million times. How we have natural kidney dialysis? More than 113,000 times. All these are blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we love our Creator, then we will not say Islam is hard, we will not hide our identity, we will be proud of Islam. We will do the worship with love to Allah. It doesn't matter for you, dear brothers and sisters, whether you are working and it's time for salah or not. You want to please Allah, and this is the first priority in your life because you love Allah and you worship Him, and you do not care for whoever says anything about you because you have iman like mountains inside you. Inna Allah amarakum bi amri balaghihi min nafsi wa thanna bi malaikati musabbihati al-quds wa dallata bisma yu'minuna bi jinni wa insi qala inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu تسليما اللهم توفنا مسلمين وارحمنا بالصالحين اللهم اكتب لنا الخير حيث كان اللهم اطل اعمارنا في طاعتك واحسن اعمالنا واغفر لنا يا رب العالمين اللهم اكشف عنا الوباء والبلاء اللهم ان كورونا جند من جنودك لا يزول الا باذنك يا رب العالمين اللهم اكشف عنا الامراض والاسقام برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم اشف عبدك ابو اسحاق يا رب العالمين اشفه شفاء لا يغادر منه سقما يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف امتك ام احمد شفاء لا يغادر منه سقما اللهم اجمع لابين الأجل والعافية اللهم اشف مرضانا جميعا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا يا رب العالمين اللهم اصلح حال أبنائنا واهدهم سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار تم الكلام ربنا محمود وله المكارم وعلى العلا والجود وعلى الحبيب محمد صلى صلواته ما ناح قمري وأورق عود وقوموا إلى صلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قام